Since the beginning of the century, maternal mortality rate in sub-Saharan Africa has shrunk by 35%, and the mortality rate for children under 5 has dropped by 50%, according to the 2018 UN report on Sustainable Development Goals. More than 100 countries have put in place initiatives in favor of sustainable consumption and production. However, in some regions, progress is insufficient to reach the objectives and targets of the program by 2030.
Finding financial sources, even though these are currently running low, may not be the main problem. The main problem is to know what will these funds be used for, how will it be used, who will use it, what's the efficiency of their use. These are the first set of questions. The other great concern is a question of taking charge of things ourselves. It is important that our countries, who for a long time have focused on development aid to fund their programs, start taking care of themselves, which doesn't necessarily mean that development aid must be completely ignored. It is there, it should be used, but used as a complement to domestic resources that countries are called to mobilize and that countries are capable of mobilizing, if they give themselves the means and put in the effort to find the financial resources where these can be found. So where can you find them? You will find them in improved budget efficiency. You will find them in the revision of tax policies, in a better and more efficient use of the fund for migrants, in the fight for illicit financial flows and capital leaks, etc., etc. So there is a whole range of actions and measures that can be taken and that will enable to improve efficiency and to optimize the funding of SDGs.
It's in this sense that a high-level workshop on the funding of sustainable goals was recently organized in Dakar, the Senegalese capital city. These meetings were organized as an initiative of the African Institute of Economic Development and Planning, IEDEP, and the Investment Agency of the United Nations, the UNCDF.
The objective of this meeting is to identify the new ways of funding, the terms and conditions of new fundings, whether these are innovative fundings, for example, the climate fund or public and private partnerships, because we have a gap in terms of SDG fundings, and this is one of the challenges. So the question is, how do we reduce this gap so that we can put in place the SDGs? I think the second challenge is how to have access to funding in order to enable the implementation of the Sustainable Development Goals. These are key questions that we will be discussing today. It is clear today that public aid to development remains important, but it will not be sufficient to finance Sustainable Development Goals. So you need to both change the scope in terms of scale and to open up to new finance opportunities. The Plan Sénégal Émergent targets new opportunities in terms of engaging with the private sector. So one of the questions is how to associate the private sector more in Senegal in the framework of the implementation of the Sustainable Development Goals, but also how to take into consideration new mechanisms, innovative fundings, such as the private-public partnerships, such as the climate funds, such as digital solutions that can really offer new platforms to help finance these sustainable development goals in Senegal.
According to estimations by the United Nations, the annual investments required to realize the SDGs reach amount to over $5,000 billion. Indeed, the APD, the public aid for development, is equivalent to less than 3% of the amount. Even if the rich countries fulfill their commitment by dedicating 0.7% of their national revenue to the development aid, the resulting amount covers, at the most, 1/15 of the needs. Thus, fundings remain the main challenge for the World Partnership to reach the SDGs.
Nous avons donc traité dans un premier point des
We covered in the first point the sources, instruments and mechanisms of internal funding through the state budget and territorial authority. We also spoke about funding through the private sector. We covered fundings from other actors, such as taking advantage of certain instruments related to external funding, such as direct foreign investments, and such as bilateral cooperation and multilateral cooperation. There is also another important aspect, which is the mobilizing of resources from the diaspora. These amounts exceed the amount of public aid for development. We are talking about the amount of foreign investments received directly in our countries that we must mobilize and orient better to reach productive results. The private sector can contribute on a national level with activities carried out here and there. The direct foreign investment, that is the international private sector, can also help through investment projects that are related to some of the 17 Sustainable Development Goals or in relation to the aspirations of the 2063 agenda of the African Union.
Pour atteindre les ODD, pour atteindre les objectifs de développement durable.
The funds that are currently available and the development fund is not enough to reach the SDG by 2030. So we need to work in a different manner to finance development. We need to put in place innovative funding mechanisms. We need to put in place what we call blended finance system, which means helping development aid to be a lever to mobilize other funding resources, knowing that this also entails risks for the less developed countries, because this development aid must reach the more vulnerable. So the mechanisms that are set up, if it supports the private sector and public partners, must also include the aspect that it can fully fulfill its role. What is important is to find opportunities to invest in Africa. Today, when you have a little bit of money, you will immediately turn to real estate. You can see that in Dakar, there are buildings being built everywhere. But you need to find systems that make it possible to channel available investments toward productive investments. So you need to strengthen the capacity of enterprises to take out loans, to pay back loans. And that applies for public-private partnerships. You must be able to structure projects that enable investors to build trust in them so that they will make investments.
Aux investisseurs d'avoir confiance et de pouvoir investir.
Even though as a whole individuals live better than 10 years ago, the efforts made to include everyone as to leave no one neglected have not been fast enough to reach the targets of the 2030 program. Indeed, the progression rate on a global level does not follow that required by a very ambitious program, making it necessary for countries and shareholders at all levels to take immediate and intensified measures.
Donc il y a toute une panoplie d'actions, de mesures.
There is a whole range of measures that are known that can be taken that make it possible to improve the efficiency and to optimize the funding of SDGs. There is today an annual deficit of 230 million for the continent that has been identified. There is a whole range of measures that are known that can be taken that make it possible to improve the efficiency and to optimize the funding of SDGs. There is today a deficit of 230 million for the continent.
Annuels qui sont identifiés.
Mobiliser les ressources, de les augmenter.
We need to mobilize resources and increase them in addition to the 50% of funding that have been already mobilized. And as I said, this should be done on a national level through the state budget, through tax revenue. That is where you need to mobilize more and carry out better steering. It's also about paying bonuses to actions that are beneficial to the environment when taxation is operated for activities that have harmful consequences on the environment. It's about broadening the tax base to all those who are capable of paying. For the territorial authority, there are activities to be carried out. To decentralize cooperation, for example, that is one of the actions that can be taken. There is also the collection of tax revenue for the local authorities so that they can carry out on their own investments in education, in health and in hygiene, as there are in fact all the fields covered by the Sustainable Development Goals.
Les objectifs de développement durable.
The realization of the 2030 program requires immediate and energetic measures from countries, with partnerships between governments and shareholders at all levels. This ambitious program calls for a deep modification that goes beyond habitual change.